saw wood to the whiskey on the strip. You can hear the crashing, blasting strum of bands that come to be real hip and get a record contract from the talent scouts today. They'll sell the rest, their cocks and balls, they'll take the check and walk away. If they're lucky, they'll get famous for a week or two perhaps. They'll buy some ugly clothes to wear and hope the business don't collapse before some stupid magazine decides they're really good. They're a Tinseltown rebellion band from downtown Hollywood. Tinseltown rebellion. Tinseltown rebellion band. It's a little Billy Tinseltown rebellion. Tinseltown rebellion band. They used to play all kinds of stuff, and some of it was nice. Some of it was musical, but then they took some guy's advice. To get a record deal, he said there would have to be more punk. Forget their chops and play real dumb, or else they would be sunk. So off they go to SIR to learn some stupid raps. And when they think they've got it, they launch a new career. Who gives a fuck if what they play is somewhat insincere?
Let's dance the blues again, get down, dance the blues again, everybody, dance the blues again, hey!
I write the songs that make the young girls cry.
Did you know that in Tinseltown, the people down there think that substance is a bore? And if your new wave group looks good, we'll hurry on back for more of leather groups.
Eye to eye,
oh, rock you like a nincompoop. And plastic boots.
Whip it good.
And groups that look real queer. I tumble for ya. The Tinseltown aficionados come to see and not to hear. But then again, the system works as perfect as a dream. It works for all of those record company pricks who come to skim the
cream
from the cesspools of excitement where Jim Morrison once stood. It's that Tinseltown rebellion from down, down, down,
down, down, down,
town, town, town,
down, down, down,
la, la, la,
la.
Downtown Hollywood, an incredibly ugly little town. It's really boring.